Growing up, I've always been afraid of the doctor. I get a little sick to my stomach just thinking about it, but now that I'm almost 40, or okay, I'm a little bit over 40, and because I'm adopted and don't know my family medical history, my wife Carol has been, let's say, encouraging me to get a colonoscopy, and I figured to make peace at home, it was time. And thanks to my friends at North Hills Endoscopy Center in Fayetteville, I had nothing to be afraid of.
I'm going to leave you, and we're going to let you slip out everything from the waist down. If you have socks on, you can keep them.
All right.
Okay? And just leave the things right up here on this table behind me, and we'll make sure they get sorted in the bed before you actually change, okay?
Is this my collar you change?
It's perfect. I think it's all you. And once you've changed out, just lay back and cover up with that sheet, and we'll be back with you in a few minutes. We'll get your IV started.
Here's one more question. Can I go to the bathroom one more time?
Absolutely. Right. Follow me.
John Moore, gastroenterologist. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Well, how did yesterday go?
It was okay. I wasn't as bad as I thought it would be.
Well, it's about 8 o'clock the night before my colonoscopy. Mixed up my liquid refreshment. This helps me clear out my system, so to speak. I'm told this is the worst part. I have to stop a little bit. It's not horrible. I wouldn't order it at a restaurant. Ugh. Well, it's just about time for me to go to bed. Feeling pretty good. Spent a lot of time on the throne. Good morning. It's round two.
Sure you don't want to take an extra bottle of that home?
I'm good.
Well, the name of the game here is to prevent you from dying of colon cancer.
Okay.
The way that we do that is we go throughout your colon and look for these precancerous polyps. And if we see these polyps, we'll remove them on the spot and collect them and send them to the lab to have them tested.
I'm ready to go. I'm ready to get this over and, hopefully everything comes out all right. I guess it did last night too, but...
Okay, we're going to go ahead and get started. We're coming through the sigmoid colon. It's toward the end of the colon. It's one of the most tortuous areas of the colon. And I think he has a small polyp right there. That is really tiny. Here's another polyp. Let's have a snare for this. Put this in the same jar as the last polyp. Alrighty, we're all done.
Okay, so we found a couple polyps in your colon. They're small.
Okay.
Nothing scary. No cancer or anything like that. And they've been removed completely. Here's one small polyp which we removed there, and another one there. And so they're gone, and the rest of your colon look just fine. No abnormalities. So what we're doing from this point is we'll send these over to the pathologist. He'll look at these polyps, figure out whether they're precancerous polyps or not.
Looked a little bit out of it there, didn't I? Dr. Moore called me yesterday and gave me my results. The two polyps he removed were precancerous, which is a good thing. Although the polyps could have eventually turned into cancer, they've been removed from my body. I'm so blessed to have gone in and had my colonoscopy. If I would have waited... well, it may have been too late. I encourage all of you out there to get this done because of my polyps. I have to go back in 5 years. Take it from a guy who isn't afraid of the doctor anymore. It may save your life.
It may save your life, and that's the important thing about what you did.
It's all good.
It's all good. And now your wife and the family can rest.
Much harmony in the Jacques household, and I encourage you. I know that you have not had one yet.
No, I've not had one yet, but
I'm going to. It's easy. Trust me out there.
Hey,
trust me.
You were asleep the whole time.
The whole time.
To be clear.
I don't have recollection of any of it.
Yeah.
A very simple process, and the night before was the worst, but certainly
easy,
I feel a lot better. Yep.
Good. We're so happy for you.
Thank